The Pet Power program has been set up where volunteers and their friendly dogs go and visit people in the community. So usually the people they visit are the isolated elderly or adults with a disability. The volunteer and their dog go into the person's home and they have a friendly, relaxed visit, everyone enjoying themselves. We do assess all the volunteers that come on and the pets.
My caseworker asked me if I would like to do it because she knew I'd lost my little dog. And I was very happy to do so because I do love dogs.
I just attended the orientation day, which was a lot of fun.
And that's free of charge. The RSPCA are helping us as a community organisation. And then we have the volunteer and the dog, we try to match them with a client in the community who has similar needs or similar interests.
Well, I think they matched us up pretty much straight away. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, and we have
yes.
a good time.
Yes.
Yeah.
We've found that with this Pet Pals program, we have quite a range of clients. People that have maybe previously owned a pet or have always wanted to but now currently can't own a pet, but they understand that there's lots and lots of benefits to being around animals. It just brings them joy.
And I said, if she found out that I love dogs, and of course we're not allowed them in the village, unfortunately.
We have other clients that also love to reminisce all about the dogs they had in the past. And I've been to one gentleman's house and he had photo album for every dog that he'd had in his life. And he had about 10 photo albums of all these lovely animals that he had. So we also have younger people maybe that might have a disability that stops them owning their own dog. So we have quite a different range of clients that get a lot out of the program, different things out of the program. There's lots of benefits that we've found people have by having contact with friendly animals. There's scientific evidence around the concept now. It's becoming a bigger field.
Oh, it's lovely. It's absolutely lovely. I look forward to it every couple of weeks when she says she can come to see me. I really look forward to it.
One of the things that they've found happens is that more happy hormones get released. So the endorphins that make you feel good when patting a dog or interacting with an animal, they've found it can lower blood pressure in people with high blood pressure. It also helps people relax. When there's a dog in the room, suddenly it's like a social lubricant. Everyone can talk about the dog and enjoy the dog, and there's not so much of an intense pressure between the people to be talking the whole time. There's also the benefit of dogs are very playful and joyful, and they just make us laugh. And a lot of the people that we visit might not have that sort of interaction in their everyday lives. One of the big things the clients find is they don't have to have the responsibility. They might not be up to walking a dog every day or taking the dog to vet assessments and visits or the vaccinations, but they still really want to interact with an animal. Maybe it's something they've had all their lives. So this gives them an opportunity to enjoy an animal, maybe even spoil an animal or give it a brush, that type of thing, without the full responsibility of owning a dog. We're having great success with the program. Really, it's win-win-win. The volunteer is having a great time enjoying their dog, enjoying a new person. The person being visited is having someone visit them and they don't feel so isolated and they feel connected. And the dog's having a great time with everyone, enjoying its company. So everyone's having a great time and it's very, very easy.
Sorry, once more.
Again?